Mini Music Monday. 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 Welcome to Mini Music Monday.
Is it still going to be Monday? Are we going to actually pop this out on Monday? Is it going
to
give birth today?
It's Tuesday for me right now.
Well, you're living in Tuesday. I'm still living in Monday.
I'm living in Tuesday.
Did I just give you an amazing song idea?
Living in Tuesday. Living in Tuesday. That's a good new wave song. Living in Tuesday.
What about Tuesday? Oh my gosh. I know it's Tuesday. Tuesday evening? It's already like the night are you already getting ready to go into Wednesday? Or no,
it's Tuesday morning for me.
So it's like the end of Monday night for you. It's Monday morning for me, but
it's 12:29.
Okay. Lou is rocked out in Adelaide, Australia.
I'm rocked out and I'm feeling a little knocked out now. Now that you've popped up on the screen and your dulcet tones are putting me to sleep, I'm like, oh, like you're in my headphones talking, and it just, do you have that too? Like if I start talking to you when you're tired, it just relaxes you more, and you're like,
it's good. So what you're saying is I just put you to sleep.
No, I'm saying it. I'm just. Well, right now you are, because I've had a full day. I've spent a full day. I woke up a very long time ago.
Yes, I can relate. I can relate. Sometimes
I woke
when
up
I'm
a long time
bed,
ago.
You're texting me as I'm like at the end of my day. Your texts make me fall asleep, and then next thing I'm.
And I was like furiously texting you while you were trying. Yes. You're going to sleep. I'm like, it was like 2 o'clock in the afternoon for me. And I'm like, my mind
You're
is sort of
fire.
Like, I'm on fire. My brain cells are firing. I'm on some, you know, introspective trip. And you are like, baby, I gotta go sleep.
Yeah.
but it's like your actual voice, you know, it's like 1 o'clock. It's almost, you know, 12:30 for me. So, I was ready. I came back from the show. I came in. I set up the microphone. I got everything going.
Yeah.
I practiced the song I'm gonna play, and then I was feeling energized, and now
I log in and you're like, say hello.
You just start talking to me, and I'm like,
Time for bed.
Maybe I should try to play my song before.
Let's do that before you fall asleep. Okay.
This might be a little rough.
Mini music snooze day.
This might be a little rough. I'm going to play another song that I recorded with Dinosaur Jr. It's from that same record. What is the name of the record?
Give a Glimpse of What You're Not. Love Is. You're going to play Love Is?
Love Is. Yeah, this All is right. like... This was the duo of songs that I wrote right after we met. And not met. Oh, God. Not after we met. After we got together.
After we became a couple.
After we became a couple.
And is so it? I can't remember. So, yeah, this must be. Well, I don't know if this was right after. This was from 2016, I think.
No, because I remember rehearsing I remember John Maloney helping me with the drum beats for this in the house. We had just moved.
We already lived here. That's what I'm saying. It didn't come out until 2016.
Well, but we did it in 2000. I don't know. John and I did a demo for it. In the living room, which is, or in the second living room, which is now your office.
Yes, that's right. We set up
some drums.
This came out in August of 2016.
Right.
So Izzy August was
already of 2000. Holy. Yeah. But maybe she wasn't when I was demoing it. I don't know.
I was pregnant.
Okay.
I was pregnant.
There we go.
So this was, yes, we were met and married at this point.
Well, it was like 3 years into it when I wrote the song.
Only 3 years in. Yeah. Only 3 years in when you wrote this song. Is it for me? Is it a love song for me? You don't
kinda,
have to answer that.
Kinda. I would say yes it is. This is like the
Is this about me?
This is, yeah, I don't know. Well, you can figure that out. Let's discuss it after.
Love is Adelle.
After I stumble my way through this, this could be like, I'm just, if I make a mistake, Adelle,
all right,
everybody, I'm just going to plow through it. Okay.
Okay. I'm your captive audience. Oh, shit. I'm sorry. I forgot it started so quickly.
Does it? Sorry. I don't know. I can start however I want.
I mean, you do like one strum and then you start singing. Because some songs have like, you know, a little bit of a musical intro and then I'm going to be quiet now.
So. Here we go. You said it all the time, but it had grown so thin. A light the light can't find, a shadow wrapped in skin. Let it fall on you, let it pin you down, until you tell the truth, yeah. No matter what they say, there's no reward for pain. So if you've asked for it, don't ask for it again. And let it fall on you, let it pin you down, until you tell the truth, yeah. Careless, what I wished for, what I did, but ruthless, once I had a taste of it, if I lose it all to get it, that's a choice that I have made. Of the life above the law, love is the law. Love is the law. So let it fall on you, let it pin you down, until you tell the truth. Here comes the age where forgiveness is a sin. If you're still so full of rage, that only poison lets you in. Now don't forget it. No, don't deny what you saw. Love is the law. Love is the law. Let it fall on you. Let it pin you. Until you tell the truth, yeah.
That's not about me.
Well, it's about, you know, it's about getting together with you. It's not like, you know.
Well, it's just about a life-changing song. It's like you're just changing your life, yeah.
It's because love is the law. So when we was in love, when we decided, I don't know, when the love happened, it was like, okay, time to move on. Time to go with the love. Love is the law.
love is the law.
You know what I found out?
It's the law.
I don't know why I didn't call the song Love is the Law. I just called it Love is. I'm like, why did I do that? I do that often. It's like I'll write a song and there's an obvious title and then I won't use the obvious title.
Mm.
Like I had that song, I called it State of Mind,
mm-hmm.
and it was obviously meant to be called Calves of Champions.
I'm okay with that one being called state of mind because I don't like the word calves.
That's one of your buttons.
That's like, one of my buttons. Like, why are you talking about that body part in a song? I don't know. I mean, I love you, dear, but I just highlighting the calf.
You're like,
it's not for me. It's too much. It's not in my top 10 Lou Barlow songs.
Hey, that's a pretty good song. I don't know. I like that one. I tell a story about what I'll.
Oh, maybe I know. You like it. You're welcome to like it. It's your song.
Well, I'm going to play it for you now.
No.
Not right now.
I'm good.
Not now.
I'm good.
Not now.
I'm good.
Not now by any means. This is like the last event of my day. I actually pulled that off. I actually played that song without fucking it up. I was a little wobbly.
You did. You paid it. You played it.
I was a little wobbly. My pitch was a little wobbly.
That's okay. It is raw impressions, you know. So yeah, it's all right. You're doing your best.
Okay. I wanted to ask you this. There's a line in the song. It's like, no matter what they say, there's no reward for pain. I'm like, is there a reward for pain? I mean, there is, I suppose, reward for pain. I was trying to say that there was no reward for like emotional pain after a point. Do you know what I mean? It's not like working out. Like if you work out or you have to learn something, or if you're like, you know, there is pain and there is reward for that pain if you're working out or you want to like, but.
Sorry, go ahead.
I was just saying so every time I sing that line, I'm like, is that like wrong or.
Well, you know, it's funny. I've never really thought about that before, but now that we're talking about it and I'm thinking about that line, it's kind of, you know, there are some people who really want to almost feel rewarded for their pain. Do you know what I mean? Like they almost want like a trauma medal. Does that make sense? You know,
it does, like, because
look at my pain, you know, really want you to give me my medal for just living. And I think that's maybe what you're talking about is like, there's no reward for it. It's like, it's just,
well, I think I was in a personal way. I was thinking that like, yeah, by going through difficult times with someone in a relationship, you know, that you sort of feel like by enduring a pain, there will be a reward for that. That maybe at some point things change. Maybe at some point the person realizes that you're in pain and says, and gives you this heartfelt sorry. And there's sort of this transition that happens, this transformation that occurs. And that's what I'm referring to in the song. So you know what?
Okay.
I'm glad we're talking about it because I love playing that song because I like that song too. I like it too, and it felt really. Dinosaur Jr. played that for a while. That was my song that we played. There's always like one original song of mine in a set, and so that was like there was a season when that was the song that we played, and I really enjoyed it. And Jay played it really well.
Yeah, I could see that being really good live.
Yeah, there's a really good lead part in it, and Jay would really dig into the lead, and it felt great. And but now I've played it acoustic. I started playing it acoustic again, and when I hit that line, like, there's no reward for pain. This is dumb, but I was on Instagram, and I'm following some manly men on Instagram right now. I'm probably going to unfollow them pretty soon, but some pretty manly, you know, manly guys. And they're like, there, you must go through pain. And like, I was watching this guy and he's like, you know, I realized early on that I could endure pain. And I knew that by enduring the pain, I could overcome my limitations. And you know, it's not about talent. It's about the ability to survive pain. and to become a better and to become a better person, which is all like kind of true. I mean, it's like the guy's like,
I was gonna say, I think that line could be taken multiple ways. Like, if you're talking about it like that, I think there absolutely is a reward for pain. Like, for example, I've been working out on the treadmill. It's very painful, but is there a reward that I'm getting like stronger and I'm feeling better and it's helping me with some of my mental health issues? Absolutely. You know, so there's lots and lots of instances where there's rewards for pain. Like maybe you have to really crunch for an exam, you know, and it's painful in all sorts of ways, you know, like you're up late at night and you're really worried about it. And, you know, but then the next day you get up, you ace it. There's a reward. So I think there's lots of ways to see that line. And then, you know, so I think there can be a reward for pain. I think that there absolutely can be. I think if we're talking about like what I said earlier, where it's more of like a bitter kind of resentment about like, more of like an attention thing, like look at my sadness, I want to be rewarded for my sadness, then I think I don't really know if that's truly a reward. You know what I mean? Yeah. That's just, you're just your shitty attitude. But like, I think, but I think that there's lots of rewards for pain. So
but yeah. Maybe not in a relationship so much.
Well, I don't know. I mean, you know, we've had some painful fights and the reward is that we come out of it understanding each other better and I think communicating better.
I was just feeling better about that line and now I'm thinking, wow. Well, maybe, I don't know. Maybe, I really...
Maybe sometimes, you know, there's no reward for pain. You could change it. You could add sometimes to it.
And in this particular...
In this particular instance, there was no reward.
And in this particular case, there's no reward for pain. And in this particular case, there's no reward for pain.
In this very, very specific instance, there was no reward for the pain.
Oh, okay. Well...
Oh, okay. Well, can you say there is a reward for pain then? Can we switch it up? How can we say there is a reward for pain?
Well, that just feels good. No matter what they say, there's no reward for pain. It just feels good. Feels good. And you know what? It's for me. I wrote that song for me.
It was for a moment.
I know what I'm talking about, and I'm right in that case. I do feel like sometimes I'm like, oh, the song has to speak to,
you know, all the anybody. Time.
You know, it has to speak to everyone. But I think in that case, no, you know,
yeah,
all
it's,
right.
It's yeah, I think it's okay. You can leave it in there. You could leave it in. Right. Just like you can leave your calves in your song.
You don't like ugh.
I'll allow it.
Mini Music Monday. Goodbye.
Goodbye. Not so many. 18 minutes.
Yeah, fuck.